Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. My name is Claudio. So glad that you're here. If you're a first time or returning visitor, thank you so much for stopping by. Adobe Firefly was recently taken out of beta and into the full version. And in Adobe Express, we have some of the generative AI features from Adobe Firefly built into it. And today I'm gonna walk you through how you can generate images based on text that you input. If you're interested in the text effects, check out my other video. So let's go ahead and dive right in. Here I am at the home screen of Adobe Express, and what you'll see to start off here on the home screen, you have two sections here for the generative AI, text to image and text effects. If you wanna learn more about text effects, check out my other video about generating text effects. Now, today we're gonna look at the text to image. So here on the home screen, you see different examples of generated images based on text that was inputted. Also, just to let you know, up here at the top, you have a generative AI menu option where basically you'll see these two types of generative AI tools. Now, the first one here, what you wanna do is enter a descriptor of text. Now, I use this the other day to create a backdrop for this project that I did using my Batman figure. You can check it out right here on the screen. And I wanted to find an image of Gotham City. Now, instead of going on the web and looking for one, what I did was enter description. So I'm gonna go ahead and show you what I entered here, which was ledge overlooking Gotham City on a dark night. And I'll click on generate. And what happens, it opens up into the project right here in the editor, and you can see that the AI right here is generating the image. So I had this choice, which is this one looks really neat. And if I click right here at the bottom, you can load more and see all the different results that are generated based on what you inputted. Now, this one was not one that I was looking for. I wanted a ledge that was a little closer to the edge, something like this one right here. This one, which was really neat. The really cool thing about this is you will see different results. What I entered the other day, I'm not seeing the same results. So if you happen to come to the Adobe Express project and enter some text and you're like, oh, I'll try again later, you're gonna get different results. So just be aware of that. I haven't seen the same results. So what I do, if I find something that I like, I'll save the project, which is already in here in my account. So I can always come back. I'll right here at the top, I'll go ahead and call this Gotham backdrop just so I can find it later on when I'm working on my project. I'm gonna go ahead and put 01 just in case I already have another project name like that. And so this was great for a backdrop. Now, this is done in a square format. And if you choose to resize here, and so let's say, you know, I wanted to use the video YouTube size, like a 1920 by 1080, which is what I use for my backdrop in my project. What will happen here is if I double click here, open up the project, and let's say I want to go widescreen, this will happen. It will get cropped. And so now I can go ahead and size it to fit my canvas here. Now, if I double click again, then I can move it down. So if you wanted more of that picture, so here's what you would want to do. So I'm going to go ahead and back out here, go back home to the home screen of Adobe Express. And as now you see different examples here. And for this time, what I'll do is click on the blue plus sign and I'll choose landscape, as this is the size that I want for the backdrop that I use for my project. And it says video there, but we're gonna go, first off, let's call this Gotham backdrop, and we're gonna call this 02, or say 03. And here I'll choose media, and we have photos, video, audio, but right here within your photos menu in media, you have text to image right here. So you can go ahead here and choose a size. In this case, this is going to be widescreen, so I'll choose widescreen. And I'll go ahead and enter the same prompt. And as I mentioned, you'll see different ones. I'm gonna go ahead and let this generate. And then I'm gonna walk you through some of the options that you have here in the menu once the image is generated. Perfect. So let's go ahead right now and let's resize this so we can see the entire image here. Actually, I wish I would have gotten these results the other day. I was working on this Batman project. Let me make this full screen. There we go. And oh, let's click it back up. And here we have the image menu. We have text to image. You see all the different results. And again, you can load more. And AI will generate here different results for that prompt. This kind of has a Ghostbusters feel right there. Very cool. I've got some trailing little characters, which I don't want in my scene. Let's see what we have here. So all these are really, really great examples of backdrops of Gotham City at night. Now, here in the content type, you have graphics, you have none. So what you'll want to do is click through all those different ones and you'll get different results here in your screen or in your canvas. So I'm gonna let this one generate. And so now there's more of a realistic look to that backdrop. It's as if I took a photo of Gotham City. Now, for this project, I did not want it to have that. I wanted it to be kind of a graphic feel. And then here you have these options, this style. You can go synthwave, digital art. I'm gonna go ahead and go with digital art and click on generate. So let's see what we get for the prompt. Again, we still have the same one, ledge overlooking Gotham City on a dark night. So let's see what comes up. And there we go. So we've got digital art. So very similar. There are some subtle differences, very subtle when you go through and choose different ones. And so let's see this one right here. So what I'm going to do is clear all and let's go synthwave. Let's see what comes up with synthwave. I'm just curious on the synthwave. I think of 80s style, you know, because those 80s color synth music in the early 80s. Okay, there we go. So we've got kind of that neon look, which is probably not what I want to have for my backdrop that I shared with you, that photo of the Batman. And what I just did is, let me go back and regenerate this. And here we go. So what I did is downloaded this project and just took it to full screen and used it as the backdrop and set up my Batman so that I can use this again as a backdrop. And so, which was a lot of fun, and not having to go search on the web for a picture. And I found just the right one that I can use for my project. So I'm going to do one more thing and just have a little fun with AI here, the generative AI. And then we'll call this a day here. So I'm going to go ahead and click on the home button to head back home. And the really neat thing here is the better you enter a description, I sometimes call it the prompt. You want to prompt it. So what I'll do here is Samurai Panda wearing red sunglasses, eating a slice of pizza, sitting on a bench in the jungle. Super specific prompt here. So I'm going to go ahead and click generate. And then to see what comes up for my prompt, the more specific you are, it gets the more detail. So there we go. There is the samurai, I should say, the panda samurai wearing the red sunglasses, eating a slice of pizza, sitting on a bench in the jungle. Very cool. And so I'm gonna go here and let's go with a photo style just to have a little fun, hit generate and see what comes up. So it'll be a photo realistic looking panda as well. So there we go. Very cool. So there you have the fun that you can have with generative AI in Adobe Express to generate images that you can use for tons of projects, tell your stories, use it for backdrops, use it for your projects. If you're looking for that right photo, just describe it and most likely you'll get the result that you are looking for.
And that's how to generate AI images in Adobe Express. So now it's your turn to give it a try. If you have any comments or questions about this video, feel free to drop it in the comment section below. Don't forget, hit that like button, subscribe, click the bell to be notified for future videos, and please share this video with your friends so that YouTube shares it with a wider audience. Thanks again for stopping by and watching this video. And as always, be good to one another and have fun creating. Until next time, peace.